All right, it's 2017. We are at the start of Hopkinton Hillers Swim and Dive. And before we start and open up in this home meet, on July 24th, 2017, the Hopkinton Swim and Dive team lost a special member of their team, Brad Canty. Brad would have been a senior this year on the team, and the team misses him every day. They pay tribute to Brad and are dedicating the season as a team, has a BC on all of their caps. He was a dedicated and a determined young man, and he loved the swim and dive team. He loved his friends, he loved his country, and most of all, he loved his family, especially his parents, Becky and Jim. We're gonna stand, and his brother Kyle, we're gonna stand for the national anthem, sang by, I believe it is Elizabeth Kane of the swim team, and we'll begin this meet dedicated to Brad. That was Elizabeth Kane, the freshman of the Hillers Swim and Dive, opening up with the national
Yeah, great job there by Elizabeth Kane.
So if it's chilly outside and there's chlorine in the air, it must be time for Hillers Swim and Dive as we enter the 2017 and 2018 season. As you look up and down the sideline, you'll notice there are some changes. The biggest of which is there's been a change at head coach. Brian King, after 20 years, has stepped down. In his place, second year coach and new head coach, Jeff Libby, has taken over. Jeff, a graduate of Natick High School in 2007, a freestyle and 50 free and 100 free swimmer, joins longtime assistant coach, Karen Terry. And for those of you who want to know, Karen Terry has pledged that she will stay on board as the assistant at least until the next Legacy swimmer is completed in 2.5 years. So we know we've got it for another 2.5 years. I'm Kevin Legacy.
I'm John Belcher.
John Belcher and Maureen Belcher on the camera as we start with diving this evening. And
yep.
See if John has the dive. You have the dive lineup or do I?
I have the dive lineup, yeah. We have Maddie, Brianna, and Jack Brennan.
So as we prep for the diving tonight, one of the things that we'll notice is that we are swimming.
Heather's first dive will be a 201A, back dive straight, 17.
We'll continue that in a sec, a back dive straight. And this is?
This is Heather Villani. She's a new diver this year.
Very nicely done.
The scores are 4.5, 4, 4.
Heather Villani, as John said, a freshman.
Yes.
Nick's first dive is a 201A, back dive straight, 1.7. Scores? 4, 4.5, 3.5.
I don't know if we mentioned this is this meet is Hopkinton versus Norton, right?
We didn't mention.
Yeah,
I was just getting ready to do the overview and intro, and we started right into the diving.
Yeah, which is unusual. I guess I've heard that the coach wants to keep it moving, so there's no second warm up.
4.5,
for his dive. I was beginning to say that we're here at Keith Tech. We will be swimming five lanes this evening as we have a broken starting block in lane six. There's a handyman anywhere that can get a starting block into Keith Tech sometime soon. That would be good. Scoring of the swimming will be for the first four lanes. Lane five will be unofficial.
Scores, six, 5.5, 6.5.
And it'll be interesting, John, to see tonight because the Hillers always rely, as you can look up and down the side of the pool as they sit attentively watching the diving. They've always relied on their depth. So with a four-lane scoring tonight, it will be interesting to see how that affects.
Yeah, I agree.
The Hillers team.
Yeah, I've heard it's going to be a 30-day wait for that lane six post.
Well, that's not good. Maddie Stouse, senior diver and captain. Should mention also this year,
seven and a half,
Hillers are led by senior captains on the boys' side, Ian Holmes, junior Jack Brennan, and junior Zach Halbro. And for the women, senior Bridget Belger, Maggie Miller, Caitlin O'Connor, Maddie Stouse, Rachel Zale. So your announcing crew and film crew, proud parents of senior captain.
Yep. I think we should also mention that Hopkinton has typically had a very strong dive group. And I know we lost several senior divers in the last couple of years, and hopefully the younger crew can come through. I know they'll be led, of course, by Maddie.
Four and a half, five.
And Brianna has been diving for the last couple of years.
Jack, second dives at 203.
As well as Jack Brennan.
Back, 1.5, somersault tuck, two.
Yeah, that is a great point, John. Last year, I think that the female divers were first in the state, 1 and 2 in the state, or 1 and 3 in the state. Maddie and
Lissy Annenberg.
Lissy Annenberg.
Who's now diving at UConn.
Divers are
five and a half.
The divers are coached by longtime coach Jim Brainerd, who pretty much coaches every high school in Massachusetts and several colleges as well. He is the man when it comes to diving in the Commonwealth. I think the other thing we should mention is Coach Libby, Jeff Libby, off to a great start as head coach. He has amassed a 2-0 record the first two meets. Hillers in a meet at Medfield, which was a league meet, defeated Medfield and also defeated Dedham on the 12th. And as John said, this is a meet against Norton. Also a league meet. Hillers are the defending champions of the Tri-Valley League. And since its inception, I believe, have only lost one TVL title. So some big expectations for Jeff Libby, and so far he has stood up to the task.
Yeah, I haven't, this is my first meet of the year. I haven't seen him in action. I know Coach King was an amazing presence on the sidelines, and I think Jeff takes a different take on it, which is a different stylistically very different.
So quiet confidence to this young man. Like I said, a 2007 graduate of Natick High, then went out to Arizona State Sun Devil. He did not swim in college, but did go to school with Gronkowski's brother, Chris, I think, as Gronk was over at U of A. So a little bit about him. I think he came in last year with the intention of eventually assuming the assistant coach, as Karen Terry is for the last at least 15 years she's been coaching, threatened to. Every year is going to be her last year.
Yeah, I think it's a big job. There's a lot of coordination between the meets, the practices, the parents, the kids. And so far, I've been very impressed.
Jeff works construction with his dad during the day and changes his work boots for the more casual flip-flops over there on the sidelines. There is a quiet confidence in his coaching, and I think it bodes well with this team. It's a lot of unity, a lot of team spirit.
Yep.
And if there is, and I don't think there's any lack of talent, there's plenty of talent, but whatever there might be, they make up with in sheer determination. Very gutsy group of swimmers. Nice dive.
Yeah, now I do. I will say that the season is a little shorter this year, it seems, fewer meets, and there is a lot of pressure because of that. There's not as many meets to qualify for the postseason, and I can tell you that that is weighing on certain kids.
Scores, 7.5, 7, 6.
But as you mentioned, Hopkinton typically wins a lot of meets by sheer force of volume of swimmers. This meet is going to be a little different because of this lane 6 problem. So I think this is going to be a good test of how they're going to come through.
Wonderful dive. 6, 6.5. Ooh, 7.5.
4, 6.5, 7, 7.5.
Nice. Every now and then I still got a score and test to see if we still got it, John. You know,
better you than me, I have no idea. I can tell when it's good, but I really don't know the middle numbers.
Just a swag, that's all.
Now, I will say in attendance today, I noticed a lot of alumni swimmers. I did see some of the, who? Julia Gorgel is here. Olivia Hanrahan.
These next couple of meets are
Tiana McCann.
Are great like that because you have, actually it looks like it's just the Norton meets, that's the home meet. This tends to be
7, 6.5, 6.5.
Yeah, excellent dives and scores.
Typically you would see there is a meet on January 3rd. I'm sure some of the college kids will be back for that.
Yeah, that's over at Wayland.
Oh, is it? Okay.
Yeah, that's a tri meet where it's Wayland and Holliston Medway.
Scores 6, 5.5, 6.5.
Well, the dives have been great. The scores have been phenomenal. There have been a lot of 6s, 6.5, some 7, 7.5. So Hillers again showing their strength in the diving side. It's great as they will enter the meet more than likely with a fairly sizable meet, sizable lead rather. This is a co-ed meet, so you'll see mixed heats of both boys and girls. Which is how the winter swimming is set up. Winter swimming is set up as co-ed. TVL is a co-ed league and swims as co-ed.
103C, forward, 1.5 somersaults, tuck, 1.6.
dive.
Six and a half, six and a half, six and a half.
Very nice. I believe, is that one Norton diver?
Yeah, I think so. Yep.
He looks familiar. I remember him from last year.
Now, I understand that a lot of the divers go to different pools to qualify for certain dives. So I'm sure Maddie has a lot of dives in her repertoire, but some of the younger ones are probably just building up their portfolio of dives.
Seven and a half, six and a half.
I believe there are a minimum, that's correct, for the states, there's a minimum number of dives that you must complete.
Okay.
Preliminaries and then finals. I couldn't begin to tell you which dives they are.
Yep.
They all have wonderful names and alphabet listings, so. Forward two and a half.
Scores 5-5-5. Comet's final dive is a 104C, forward two somersaults tuck, 2-2.
As we enter into, I believe, the final dives.
Now, looking at the upcoming lineup for the swim meet, I'm seeing some familiar names from previous years. It looks like the youngest Salyard boy is swimming tonight, the 53. I think he's a freshman. And I
scores 6.5, 7-6.
I'm sure as we go through the meet we'll see
Marty's
more.
Final dive is a 105C, forward 2.5 somersault tuck, 2-4.
Maddie will not be happy about that.
Well, short. That's the reaction from the water. Ow. That's unfortunate.
Yep.
Just came out of that a little early.
I couldn't tell if she slipped a little on the board, but
she came out of that a little early. So we're going to sign off and join you back when the meet starts. And we'll be starting with the 200 medley relay.
Yes, see you in a few minutes.
Start of the meet. We're going to start with the 200 medley relay.
Yep. As we mentioned earlier, because of a technical problem at the Keefe Tech pool, lane 6 is not available. So we have three lanes of Hopkinton swimmers. The fifth lane won't count for the meet, but will count for time. So in lane one, this is the 200 medley relay. Mary Lauren Burke, Alex Moustakas, Caitlin O'Connor, and Ian Holmes. Lane three, Blake Briner, Sam Cody, Andrea Way, and Cole Salyards. Lane five, which is the unofficial lane, Mallory Pischoff, Brooklyn Briner, Connor Murchie, and Lassie White.
The merch.
Oh, Connor Cassie Murchie. Cassie White. Yeah, Connor Murchie, yeah. The merch.
The merch.
Now, I will say, lane three, we're going to see the first performance in a home meet of Andrea Way, who had a couple of sisters that swam previously. I think she's going to be swimming for Brown next year. So this is her first year on the high school team. Previously of Crimson? I'm not sure.
Shawmut. Which is now Crimson. Shawmut got bought a little while ago. Those of you tracking your U.S. swim teams.
It would be great if we saw some fast times early.
Their qualifying times for sectionals. We won't really be looking at that for these because these are co-ed relays. It will be interesting at some point. The coach may put together relays of all male or all female just to start to look at qualifying times. As John has said, the season is short. So there's often a push to get qualifying times for sectionals and states. Both of those meets take place in February. It's hard to believe we were merely 6 weeks away from the TVL meet,
yeah,
which scheduled for February 2nd and 4th. Believe that is down at Wheaton College again.
Oh, really? Okay.
I don't know. Oh, is it here? Is it? Oh, that'd be good. Hopefully they've got the, hopefully they have the block secured by then. So the medley relay, 200. This will be a 50 of backstroke, butterfly, breaststroke, and free. And for your play-by-play and call on the lanes, I'm going to turn it over to John.
Yeah, in lane one, Mary Lauren Burke, Alex Moustakas, Caitlin O'Connor, and Ian Holmes. Lane three, Blake Briner, Sam Cody, Andrea Way, Cole Salyards. And in lane five, we have Mallory Pischoff in the water right now, Brooklyn Briner, Connor Murchie, and Cassie White.
As the swimmers get off to a start, you don't get excited too early as you've got men and women swimming together. So Hopkinton out to a lead in both lanes one and three.
Here we have Mary Lauren finishing up in lane one. Into the water, Alex Moustakas, Sam Cody, lane five, Brooklyn Briner.
Fifty breaststroke, two laps of the pool. Hopkinton with commanding leads in both lanes one and three. As we get ready to turn into the butterfly leg.
Into the water, lane one, Caitlin O'Connor. Lane three, Andrea Way. And lane five coming up, Connor Murchie.
Andrea Way opening it up in lane three for Hopkinton as they go into the last leg. Anchor being swum by.
Ian Holmes, lane one. Cole Salyards, lane three. Cassie White, lane five.
The Hillers look like they should easily take first and second in the 200 medley relay. As Cole Salyards comes in the middle lane, with a very unofficial time of somewhere in the neighborhood of 150.
154.38. Is that what you had? Or?
I started my watch very, very slow. Slowly.
So that's a good sign for Hopkinton on that. I think first and second, right?
First and second, lanes one and
three.
Three and one, rather. We're going to get into heat two. Heat two for Hopkinton in lane one, Holly Burns, Stephanie Kepelos, Holly Richardson, Kelly Burke. Lane two, Andrew Deleva, Sierra Schlussel. All right, these kids are going to have to come to me if I kill their names. Aditya Dutta and Peyton Salyards, then Julia Pillarella, there you go. Mia Carboni, Kaylee Cohane, and Sophie Cowan. Boy, I'm going to have to look through these ahead of time and get the names down. It's been a while. I'm back in the booth. I'm a little out of it, you know. Been a few years.
Well, how many decades has it been?
We are glad to say we are on the last Legacy child moving through. Two and a half more years. we get ready for the start of heat number two. Norton with one relay. With one relay team in lane number two. Relays are a great opportunity for the kids to get into the water as Holly Burns, Andrew Delever, and Julia Pillar with an L at the end. There we go. We're going to call her Julia or JP. She's just going to have to get used to that. Did they call her JP? There we go. That's Andrew Deleva and JP out lane three. In the water now, Sierra and Mia Carboni out in lane five. Stephanie Capellos going in lane one. The breast stroke, 50 breast, two laps. For those of you listening at home and not watching, the swimmers swimming left to right. And then they turn and they start swimming right to left. As we enter in, going into the third leg. Getting ready in lane three. Aditya Dutta. Harley Richardson in lane one and going into the water in lane five. Kaylee Cohane.
Yeah, Kaylee looks good out there in lane five.
Some good looking strokes. There are some young kids that I remember from last year that have, you see the strokes vastly improved as Peyton Salyards goes in the center of the pool for Hopkinton. 50 free, anchor leg, lane five. Sophie Cowan going in the water and Kelly Burke here in lane one. As Hopkinton swimming very well in all three lanes. And Peyton Salyards coming in. Unofficial time, somewhere around 2:10. As Norton looks to put their last swimmer in on the 53. The last leg, lane five, Sophie Cowan coming in. And then lane one, Kelly Burke wrapping up for Hopkinton. A clean sweep. Nice swim by the Pillars.
Okay, so coming up we have the 200 free. Lane one, there's Zach Holbrow. Lane two, lane three, Grace Cavanaugh, and lane five, Bridget Belger.
So in these instances on the 200 free, because these are individual events, we are looking for qualifying times for the girls' sectional qualifying at 209.87, for the boys at 156.38. 200 freestyle, one of the more grueling races. It's not a distance, it's not quite a sprint, it's right there in between. Free, eight laps of the pool. Nice pace being set by the Hillers in lane three.
Lane three, Grace Cavanaugh. I get a little distracted when my daughter's swimming.
I was just going to say, yes, I looked at John, and he's got his eye on Bridget out in lane five, as he should. So Grace Cavanaugh, lane one is?
Lane one is Zach Holbrow.
Zach Holbrow. Zach, as I recall last year, had some phenomenal time drops at the TVL meet. If I remember, I think it was the 500 freestyle. Turned in a gutsy performance.
I think it's... It's a tough race, the 200.
Zach, a junior captain. And Grace Cavanaugh in her junior year. Bridget out in lane five, senior captain.
Yep.
under the watchful eye up here of mom and dad. Norton is pressing as we've got a race on our hands now. As they turn further, we're in the final 50.
We're in the final 50, yep.
So we've got a battle between
148.
Lane four is Norton. Lane one is Hopkinton. Zach Hallbrow digging deep as he does. Looks like he will take this. Norton is second. And Grace Cavanaugh, then Bridget. Lanes 1, 2, 3, and 4 are the scoring lanes. All the times are counting. The scoring, if I think you're keeping score at home, I believe, is 4-3-1.
I got a piece of paper telling me what it was earlier, but I didn't catch it.
Well, there are official scorekeepers down there, so we will rely on them, and what we'll try to do is during the meet get you some score updates so you can, so we can have a little bit of.
Looks like Grace may have qualified sectional time.
Excellent. We will find out and get some unofficial times at some point. As we're ready for heat two of the 200, lane one for Hopkinton, Elizabeth Kane, lane three, Kate Legassi, and lane five, Kayla McCann. And I thank coach for this lineup. Oh, we've got one other Hiller in there in lane two. And I don't know who that is. And so coach has snuck one in on us. Again, second heat of the 200 freestyle. Hiller's in lane 1, 2, 3, and 5. Elizabeth Kane, the tall young man in lane two, Kate Legassi and Kayla McCann, and I apologize as we do not have his name and I don't know these guys well enough to figure out who that is. Let's see if we can find out.
Yeah, Hopkinton's got 4 swimmers out of 5, and this is what you were talking about before, the depth of Hopkinton. Of course, this isn't scored, but still a great chance to get kids out there swimming.
And you'll see that the time drop-offs are not that much different between heats 1 and 2, demonstrating the depth, which over the years has been the key to the success of the Hillers in the TVL, being able to put so many swimmers out there and so many heats and scoring points in a TVL. As we turn the 100 with Hopkinton in lane 2, Kate Legassi in the middle of the pool, lane 3, Elizabeth Kane, who sang a phenomenal version of the national anthem at the beginning of our broadcast, and out in lane 5, that's Kayla McCann.
Now, is that Tiana's sister?
I was just going to say, I believe she is the younger sister of Tiana McCann. Graduated captain from last year. Kayla is also a sophomore, Kate a sophomore. And Elizabeth Kane, as we mentioned earlier, a freshman. So some young depth. Looking at the roster, the Hillers are going to need it as they pass the three-quarter way mark. As on the men's side, they only graduate 3 this year. Ian Holmes, senior Ben Pessin, and Sam Richardson. But on the women's side, Eleven ladies will graduate this year. Hopkinton coming in, our gentleman, the tall man in lane 2. We're going to find out who he is, and he is officially dubbed the tall man.
Lane 2?
For the rest, yes. Do we know who he is?
No, I don't know.
That is Hopkinton. That's Kate Legassi coming in the lead of the women there, lane 3.
Nice.
And Kayla and Elizabeth Kane coming in about the same time. No unofficial times, but we'll try to figure out what those are as everybody is pushing to score. The Norton swimmer in lane 4,
coming in on her last leg to the cheers of the crowd. Hopkinton, very sportsmanlike team as they encourage all the swimmers. A lot of depth on that sideline. I believe it's over 45 swimmers. They had close to 65 try out this year. It's generally not a, that popular and not that much of a cut team, but they had to do that this year, had tryouts early on as the depth and the interest in the swimming program has grown considerably in the years that our family's been involved in it, and it's great to see. I'll turn it over to John.
Here we go, the 200 IM, Ritesh Rajanagan, lane one, Andrea Way, lane three, and Brooklyn Briner, lane five. Now, this is a good chance for Hopkinton to get a lot of points. Three out of the four swimmers in the pool are Hopkinton swimmers. Of course, lane five is not a scoring one, so hopefully we get a first or second. We're going to get something out of this.
As lane three jumps out to an incredible start.
Yep, that's Andrea Way.
She is, as I recall, a butterflyer. Strong swimmer. Closely followed in lane one. Andrea takes the turn, second lap of backstroke. The medley, just like the medley relay, butterfly back, breast and free. 50 of each for the 200. Andrea takes the turn into the breaststroke. Followed closely by lane one.
Lane one, Ritesh Rajanagan. I'll butcher that name all year, I think.
We're going to call him Ritesh.
Ritesh, yeah.
Take the turn. Andrea opens up a little bit more of the lead in the breaststroke, followed by Ritesh in lane one. Hopkinton cruising well to in first and second. Norton slightly behind in third place in lane four. Out lane five, that is?
That's Brooklyn Briner, who has a brother also on the team, I believe.
Brooke Briner, a senior.
Yep.
Andrew Wade coming in for the win. I don't know if we have an unofficial time.
I do not, no.
I'll try to do that. I'll try to keep a watch going. Ritesh in lane one coming in, finishing up his last leg of the 200. Another grueling race. And Brooke Briner taking her turn. And they're into her last 25. A lot of these kids, this is right around the time for any kids that have applied early decision for college. So in addition to all of their school work, there is a host of things going on in their lives, especially for these seniors. There is no second heat of the 2 IM. So John, I'm gonna turn it back over to you.
Yep, so we're saying 50, yeah, it could be. 50 free, we have Cole Salyards, lane one, Abby Fisher, lane three, and Ainsley Worrell, lane five.
50 free, the sprint event of the evening.
Okay. So it's the 50 free, Cole Salyards, Abby Fisher, Ainsley Worrell. Well, that's a change. Oh, no, Cole's out there. Okay. Yep.
We were able to get a watch on this. Cole out to a quick sprint, lane one. Followed by Hopkinton in lane three and five as the Hillers straight across into the first turn. Tightly bunched.
Maybe it's the
Cole Salyards in lane one. Who's got lane three?
Lane three, I have Abby Fisher.
And lane five is the Hiller sweep.
Rachel Zale, lane one. Ritesh Rajanagan, lane three. Tyler Holbrow, lane five.
All right.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah.
There we go. All right. So all these kids swimming that aren't getting their names said enough. We apologize as we figure out our technical things here.
No, I think we're doing 50. Oh,
that's another 50.
Second deep 50s. Yep.
Actually, you know what? That's going to be me. Yeah. So that was the second heat of the 53 with Kate Legasse, Allison Fu, and Sophie Cowan. What we missed on camera, but boy, they swam really well, was Peyton Salyards, Aditya Dutta, and Kaylee Cohane. Now we've got a fourth heat. Mia Carboni, Holly Burns, Jack Brennan. Again, we'll see if we can get some unofficial times here.
Yep. Without the diving of the 53, the score is 21-5. Hopkinton in the lead. We'll just announce that Jack Brandon is a two-way performer. He's also swimming tonight and diving.
Not an easy thing to do, as we're off in heat number four in the 53. Mia Carboni, Holly Burns, Jack Brennan out in lane five. As Jack already did his diving duties. Now out there swimming the 53. That is Mia Carboni, lane one. That's Jack coming in unofficially around 28.5, 29, 30, 31. Nice swims by Mia, Holly, and Jack Brennan. All the kids are shooting for times for the girls' sectional split. That's a 26.79 for the boys, a 23.70. Some quick times in front of these kids. We will have one more heat. Kelly Burke, Brooke Briner, and Julia Pillarella. JP. Our girl JP. We get ready, the swimmers swim down after the sprint. Heat number five. We have two gentlemen in the middle of the pool too, also swimming. This coach has added a couple other swimmers to get them some times on their 50. Swimmers are off. Kelly Burke in lane one, Brooke Briner in lane three, Julia Pillarella, JP out in lane five. We have two gentlemen swimming, first of which coming in unofficially at 26.81. Nice swim. And for the ladies, that's JP up there in lane five. That's Kelly Burke in lane one and Brooke Briner in lane three. We will move on from the 53.
Yeah, now I wonder if they're going to have to do a little warm-up. I think so.
Might take a break in between.
Yep.
Are we going into the 100 free right after this?
100 fly.
100 fly.
Yeah.
So we'll see. This is normally where the diving takes place, and there's a small break. We're going to wait and see if there's a quick warm-up or a small break or if they get right into it.
I understood that MIA rules require a warm-up mid-meet.
Mid-meet?
Yep. That's
well,
what we're seeing here.
What we're going to do is John and I could easily fill the dead air with
yes.
the silver midnight voices here of Hopkinton Hiller Swimming, but we're not going to do that to you. So we're going to take a break, and as soon as the swimming resumes, we will be back.
Okay, after our small break, we have the 100 fly. Lane one, Rachel Zale. Lane three, Ritesh Rajanagan. And lane five, Tyler Holbrow.
So we took our little break there. She got a phone call from a colleague who was a former diver in upstate New York.
Wow.
Took sixth in the state in upstate New York
way back in the 1970s.
So this is four lengths of the pool. We're at the midway point.
Hopkinton lane 3 and 5. Out to quick starts in lane 1.
That's Rachel Zale, lane 1.
And out lane 3.
We have Ritesh Rajanagan.
And up in lane 5.
We have Tyler Holbrow. Looks like it's going to be a 1-2 finish if Rachel can pull it off here.
It's going to come down to lanes 1 and 4. Again, unofficial time.
Come on.
Oh, close. Looks close. Like they're going to go 1 and 3.
Very nice. Very nice race. Looks like we have some second heats on this. Maybe not.
Nope.
Maybe not. Okay. We have the 100 free coming up. Alex Moustakas, Matsoukas, lane 1. Grace Cavanaugh, lane 3. And Colin Thine, lane 5.
We're going to have to work on all these kids' last names, or else we're going by first names.
Yep. I have to say I'm not a fan of the mixed mixed races or whatever. But
co-ed swim?
Co-ed swim, yep. I mean, of course, I have to live with it, but I don't love it.
Hundred free will run an unofficial watch from here up in the booth. High above Keith Tech. As they head into the water. Is that Alex Matsoukas?
Yep. Lane 1. Grace Cavanaugh, lane 3. Colin Thine, lane 5.
Colin is the younger brother of. Forget
you
what his
it.
Sister's name.
Yeah. There's been a long line of Thines. Yep.
Spent a whole season debating Thine or Tyne.
Yes. Jenna Thine, maybe?
Yep.
Yep. Seems like swimming runs in families.
That's because older kids get, younger kids get dragged to the swimming clubs by parents who only want to drive in one direction, so.
Yes. So we're going to get a 1-2 finish here on
Alex coming in unofficially at a 55.99.
Grace, it was going to be close, lane 2, but lane 5 was only for time.
So sectional qualifying times for the women, 58.89 for the men, 52.47. Unofficial for Alex, 55.99. As the Hillers continue to swim well, dominate in the pool. A lot of depth, in addition to strong swimmers at the forefront. We will have a second heat of the 100 free. Sierra Schlissel, Andrew Deleva, and Mallory Pishoff.
Pishoff, yeah.
Pishoff.
Scores Hopkinton 35-7 before the fly. So I will say it, it's so far been a good day for Hopkinton. And looking at the second half of the meet, looks like it's going to be okay.
Yeah, the lack of the lane and the four-lane scoring hasn't hurt Hopkinton in their depth as they have come out swimming extremely well. This 100 free second heat, Sierra, Andrew Deleva in the middle, and Mallory Pishoff out in lane 5 as Andrew Deleva takes the first turn right around a 30 point. So ladies turn right behind him. Tight race. Sierra Schlissel in lane 1, Andrew Deleva out in the center of the pool, and Mallory Kuchoff up in lane five as they take the turn at the 75, heading for home. All these swimmers swimming for times. They're also swimming for points as they look for points to contribute towards their varsity letters. Angela Deleva coming in unofficially at 103 and change. Up top, 107, 108. Nice swims by these kids. That was heat number two. Norton finishes up in lane four.
Okay, it looks like we got a 500 free coming up. Lane one, Andrea Way. Lane three, Alyssa Fisher. And the unofficial lane, lane five, Zach Holbrow. Okay, we just heard Alyssa from the producer. Alyssa has already qualified for sectionals in this event.
Is that Abby or Alyssa?
Alyssa.
Alyssa.
Lane three. Alyssa Fisher, freshman.
Oh. Is that younger sister of Abby
no,
Fisher?
No, it is not.
Okay. All right. We're getting filled in as we connect the dots here.
By the producer.
It's okay. They always know best.
Now this is a rough race. Looking for Andrea Way to do well in this one. I think she swims all year round.
Yeah, if you're watching this at home, now's a good time to go up and get a snack and get a few minutes. The 500 free is 20 laps of the pool. This race generally runs for the men and the women between 5 and 6 minutes. In some cases, 7 minutes, depending on the swimmers. A grueling race. One of stamina as well as pace as the swimmers go out quickly and get into a rhythm. You always know it's a long race when you've got a lap counter at the other end of the pool. So they take the turn, both Andrea and Alyssa setting swift paces. Did not run a clock on this. I should have. Qualifying times for the 500 for the girls for sectionals is?
It's 5:50.
Okay.
And for boys, we don't have a boy out there, right?
We do actually, out okay. In the fifth lane. Who do we have swimming out there?
For
is that Zach?
Sectionals, 5:21.
And who's that out in lane five?
Zach Holbrow.
Zach Holbrow. Yeah. Again, I don't know Zach, but I do remember a memorable and gutsy swim last year at the TVLs. He dropped, memory serves, at least 15, if not more, seconds off of his time. Swam extremely well at the TVLs.
That's a good time to swim well.
For a lot of these kids, their year culminates with the TVLs. As a select few will move on to sectionals and states. Competition in the pool and the times are set based on averages across the state. They change every year. Andrea Way and Alyssa Fisher both setting nice paces. About a body length lead for Andrea as they turn and head into.
Now I'm thinking there's one lap lead on lane two, no?
They are lapping, yep. Hopkinton takes a moment to put a fan cheer there together. And as they line up, that is a large team of swimmers. A lot of school spirit over there. As Andrea turns lap 10, heading into the second half of the race. Alyssa Fisher as well. Lane two, Norton. They are a lap behind as the Hopkinton swimmers having great swims right now. It's actually not too bad. So weather has been pretty mild heading into the holidays. All these kids with one thing on their mind to get through the next 2 days and get a week and a half's break from school or a week break from school. Andrew Way opening up a 3 or 4 body length lead as she turns on lap 13.
Yeah, she's killing it tonight.
Melissa Fisher as well, taking the turn on her 13th lap. Nice to see a good, strong, young group of swimmers. Melissa Fisher being one of them. As I said, the Hillers will graduate 11 female seniors this year, many of which have been here for 4 years, strong group of swimmers. So they will look towards their juniors, sophomores, and freshmen to backfill at the end of this season. As they turn on the 15th lap, head in for the final 100. Andrew Way's opened up a nice lead. Lane one, great stroke, great pace. It's unfortunate, I wish we had run a watch on this. I'd be curious to know what her time is. That would be,
yeah, she'll be swimming at Brown next year.
Final turn, the bell lap. Andrew Way with a half a lap lead over Alyssa Fisher, a freshman. Andrew Way, a senior, as mentioned before, swimming for Brown next year. Takes her final turn, coming into the 25. As we watch the lap counters, Alyssa Fisher turns. Her final as Andrew Way comes in, touches. Excellent swim, and I would guess that she is qualified for most likely sectionals and most likely states as
Seems
well.
Seems like it, yeah.
Melissa Fisher, because if she had qualified, what's the difference between sectionals and states time-wise?
Sectionals and states in the, for the girls, 10-second difference.
So that was about a 10-second. So if Abby Fisher is qualified, my guess is Andrew Wade is qualified. And up top, Zach Holbrow comes in, finishing.
Yeah, I couldn't tell.
His 500. Let's start to run a watch on these.
Okay, so now we have the 200 free relay coming up.
We're going to have a Norton
Team's
swimmer.
Lining up. We have a Norton swimmer still swimming,
yep,
right?
Yeah, we have a few laps left for Norton in lane two. But you can give the lineups as the swimmer's finishing
I'll
up.
I'll do it, yeah. Lane one, Cassie White, Bridget Belger, Blake Briner, Abby Fisher. Lane two, Alex Matsoukas, Grace Cavanaugh, Cole Salyards, Andrea Way. Wow, Andrea's going to get out and swim in a minute. And then in lane five, Ian Holmes, Colin Fine, Andrew DeLiva, Caitlin O'Connor.
As the Norton swimmer is going to take her last turn on the 500.
Yep.
Coming in on her last 25 to the cheers of her team, as well as encouragement from the Hopkinton team as well.
So one thing I will say is the first swimmer can qualify in the 200 free for the 50 free.
That's correct.
I don't think we're going to see any of that tonight, but that's a possibility. I think as the season goes along, the practices build in and a lot of kids get faster times. As we mentioned, Andrea Way just came out of lane one and is now anchoring lane three's 200 free relay.
So she finishes the 500, roughly 5 minutes of swimming.
After the fly, we have 47-11 Hopkinton.
The Hillers are cruising to what will be an apparent victory today.
Absolutely.
Complete team effort. It will be three events after the 200 free relay, I think.
Yep.
100 breast,
we got
100
the 100 back, breast, free, 400
free
relay. And the 400
free relay.
Yep. Now, for the 200 free, as we mentioned, Cassie White, lane one, Bridget Belger, Blake Briner, Abby Fisher. Lane three, Alex Matsoukas, Grace Kavanaugh, Cole Salyards, Andrea Way. Lane five, Ian Holmes, Colin Fine, Andrew DeLeva, Caitlin O'Connor.
After the first heat, there will be a second heat as coach works some of that depth into the 200 free relay. And the leadoff swimmers are in the water. Hopkinton jumps to an early lead in lane three with leadoff swimmer.
Cassie White, lane three, Alex Matsoukas.
Alex Matsoukas. We'll do an unofficial time on Alex as he comes in. A 25 low. Second swimmer's in the water.
We have Bridget Belger, lane two, Grace Kavanaugh, lane three, and Colin Fine, lane five. Grace Kavanaugh is killing it out there.
She's got a nice swim going. There's a handoff from Alex Matsoukas. Bridget in lane one's got a great swim going, has closed the gap and overcome the Norton swimmers in lane four. Close to an early start there in lane one. The official didn't catch it. Third swimmers in the water we have.
We have Blake Briner, lane one, Cole Salyards, lane three, Andrew DeLeva, lane five.
As Cole maintains the lead and actually pillars in lanes one and five have overtaken Norton as we go into the last leg. Final swimmers in the water, anchor swimmers in lane one.
Abby Fisher, lane one. Andrea Way, lane three. Caitlin O'Connor, lane five.
Unofficial completion time, finish 145.8. As Hopkinton takes one and two. Andrea Way looks like she could go and swim another race if she wanted to right now. She looks
absolutely
looks strong in the water. The Hillers are glad to have her back. We are going to have a lane, a heat two, as Norton finishes up. Heat two and lane one, our team consists of Marilyn Burke, Kelly Burke, Stephanie Kapalos, Harley Richardson. Lane two, Elizabeth Kane, Collar Murchie, Connor Murchie, Kayla McCann, Caitlin Gassi. And in lane five, Peyton Salyards, Mallory Pishoff, Sierra Schlissel, and Mia Carboni. I will quiz my daughter tonight on the pronouncing of everybody's last names. Or we're going to
get nicknames.
You're
getting it right, pretty much.
Yeah, we're going to get nicknames for everybody, I think.
Yeah. Now we have an unusual event here, lane one. Two sisters are swimming first and second heat, first and second in this race.
There you go, the Burke sisters.
Don't they sing and dance as well, the Burke sisters? And they're off 200 free relay. Mary Lauren Burke.
MLB,
yep. Major League Baseball is in lane one. There we go, Elizabeth Kane and Peyton Salyards.
Now, I'm not clocking Mary Lauren in this race, but as we said, the split could qualify as a time, but I don't think that's going to happen now.
Roughly 28 as the second swimmers go in. That's Kelly Burke, Connor Murch, and Mallory Pishoff. The Hopkinton swimmers pretty much straight across as they take their turns. Swimmers number two, Kelly, Connor, and Mallory. Up in the blocks, Stephanie, Kayla, and Sierra. As lane five, Mallory is pulled ahead. This is for bragging rights as much as anything else, personal times. As we've got Stephanie Kapalos,
yep.
Kayla McCann, and Sierra Schlossel. They take the turn and they are almost straight across the pool, the far end of the pool, taking the turn. Going to hand off. It's going to come down to the anchor legs. Harley Richardson, Caitlin Gassi, and Mia Carboni. Oh, this will be good. This is bragging rights for the anchor legs in heat number two. First in the water, lean one, lean three, and then lean five. That is Harley, Kate, and Mia.
Now, is the Harley Richardson of the Richardson family?
I don't know. I would say there was a more likely than not.
Yep.
As Kate Legacy in lane three anchoring, taking a slight lead over Harley, and up in lane five, Mia Carboni. Just under 2 minutes, it looked like, for the finish as all three heats come across. Good swims by everyone there. Norton is wrapping up with their anchor swimmer in the water, lean four. And as we get ready and wrap up the 200 free relay, we go to the 100
backstroke. We have lane one, Blake Briner. Lane three, Mary Lauren Burke. And lane five, Cassie White. Now, didn't I just see Mary Lauren swimming a few minutes ago? Yep.
Yes, you did. She swam in heat. She swam in the first. The first heat of the first lane of the second heat. Yep. So.
I'm gonna get some unofficial times here on this 100 back.
Run a couple of watches on this together. Yeah. Hopkinton off to a good start, lane one and three.
Okay. So after the 500, it's 54-12 Hopkinton. And we've been notified by the scoring desk the rest of the Hopkinton events will be exhibition only.
So though the times will count, there will be non-scoring, as Hopkinton has, at this point, scored enough points to win the meet. And they will. Coach Libby will notch his third victory in three tries, so he is off to an undefeated season so far in his debut season as head coach. The freestylers take a turn in the water in lane one. Leading is
Blake Briner. Lane three, Mary Lauren Burke. Lane five, Cassie White. So I'll ask you, does that mean the pressure's off? I don't know about that.
In regards to... He can relax as the Hillers unofficially lane one, 109.4, lane three, 112 low, and up in lane five, 117.3. So Hillers go 1, 2, 3. We'll head into the 100 breaststroke.
Allison Fu, lane one. Sam Cody, lane three. Sam Richardson, lane five.
It's interesting as you look at the Hiller record board. The 100 breaststroke, a record that has been in existence for over 12 years now, in February of 2005, set by Sean Terry, the son of assistant coach Karen Terry. A 59.88, quite a feat, breaking a minute at any level of swimming for the 100 breaststroke. And that is one of the oldest, if not the oldest, record on the record board as we look through it on the men's side. On the women's side, actually, there is one other one, and actually I think it is in the fly. The 100 freestyle back to 2003. Three records still held by Megan Farrell. On a breaststroke.
With Allison Fu, lane one, Sam Cody, lane three, Sam Richardson, lane five.
As the Hillers.
One, two, and three.
As the Hillers crowd the far end of the pool, cheering on the teammates, both sides.
lane five. Is that lane five? Who do we have swimming out in lane five?
Lane five, Sam Richardson.
Sam Richardson out in lane five.
He's killing it out there tonight.
He's got a good looking swim going. Sam Cody in lane three. And who do we have in lane one?
In lane one, we have Allison Fu. I'm just looking to see an unofficial time on the states and the sectionals, 106. And he's going to just be nubbed off of it, lane five. Sam made a close run for it, too.
So lane five is whom?
Lane five is Sam Richardson.
Sam Richardson, Sam Coney. So our Sam's and Allison. Allison Fu in lane one.
Allison Fu had I had unofficially 118.70. The sectional time for the breast is 117.50. 48.
So a lot of good swims here. Good times early in the season here for the Hillers as we head into the final event of the evening, the 400 freestyle.
Okay, we have lane one, Bridget Belger, Alyssa Fisher, Colin Thine, Abby Fisher. Lane three, Cole Salyards, Ainsley Worrell, Zach Holbrow, Alex Matsoukas. And lane five, Aditya Dutta, Tyler Holbrow, Caitlin O'Connor, and Rachel Zale.
So in recent days, when you look at the Hillers as a team and their records, last year, as we said, strong in the diving, the record books were rewritten by both Lissy Annenberg and Maddie Staus. The 11 dive and 6 dive records both fell last year. Previous year on the women's side, the 2 free relay went with Grace Cavanaugh, Rachel Zale, Lydia Franklin, and Olivia Hanrahan. Maybe an announcement. Nope, it's going to be an announcement. This could be the 50-50 raffle. We'll take a minute here before the last event. 50-50.
There you go.
As everybody pulls out their 50-50 raffle tickets. So this is the Canty Underdog Scholarship, as we mentioned earlier. The loss of senior swimmer Brad Canty last July. Team dedicating their season to Brad with BCs on all of their swim caps. They've been doing fundraisers and events to benefit the scholarship fund. Brad was quite a presence on the team. A young man of great determination, a lot of strength. Brad would have been a senior this year, as we're still looking for a winner for the 50-50. And I think they should just donate everything to the, just leave it in the 50-50 for the scholarship. We'll try to find out a dollar amount tonight.
Nancy Cavanaugh won that.
See a lot of tickets in the.
Donated it back to winnings.
A very nice gesture by Ms. Cavanaugh, donating back the 50-50 into the scholarship fund. So as we wrap up this evening, we're going to wrap up the 400 free. John's going to give you the lineups. As the lead official. Thanks both teams for sportsmanship. We head into the 400 freestyle. Each swimmer will swim 4 laps of the pool, 4 by 100. First swimmers in the pool, John.
Bridget Belger, lane one, Cole Salyards, lane three, Adita Dutta, lane five.
Cole Salyards having a nice evening tonight on his freestyle swimming. Bridget swimming extremely well in her freestyle events. We will get the Aditya out on lane five, also swimming strong, is
All three Hopkinton swimmers neck and neck as we turn for the first 50.
Come on, Bridget.
And it is allowed to cheer for your own son or daughter while you're announcing, so there's nothing wrong with that. We are homers, by the way.
We are.
Bridget's turning in a great swim in lane one, encouraged by Coach Jeff Libby. As the second swimmers are entering the pool.
We have Alyssa Fisher, lane one, Ainsley Worrell, lane three, Tyler Holbrow, lane five.
Hawkinton's lane one and two, swimming neck and neck. Cheer from the Hopkinton sidelines as the second swimmers take their turn to their second 50. In the pool once again on lane two.
lane, who are we in? The third here? Third swimmer?
No, just the second swimmer still.
Oh, really?
They're kids. They like to hear their names.
Okay, yeah, I know they do. Alyssa Fisher, Ainsley Worrell, Tyler Holbrow.
And we're going to lead to the third swimmers.
Third swimmers. We got Colin Fine, Zach Holbrow, and Caitlin O'Connor, lane five.
Two senior captains, right?
Yep. No, Zach is the captain, no.
Zach and also Caitlin O'Connor.
Yep.
In the water now.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, you're right.
Lanes one and three neck and neck. His coach has devised the relays to be competitive with one another as in lanes one and three. And our two swimmers in the water now are the men.
Two swimmers.
This is third, leg three.
Leg three. We have Colin Fine, Zach Holbrow, and Caitlin O'Connor.
There we go. Zach and Colin coming in neck and neck. So we turn it over to
Abby Fisher and Alex Matsoukas.
This ought to be a good race.
Yeah, right here.
Both
yeah.
Good swimmers, strong swimmers.
I tell you, Alex is turning it on.
He's having a good meet today. He looks very strong.
Looks very strong.
Alex, sophomore swimmer.
I don't remember him from last year, but he is pulling it out.
He takes great offense to that, too.
I know, everybody, they listen all the time.
I know. Hey, it's the most popular program on
HCAM, yeah.
HCAM.
Nice swim, Alex.
Alex is opening up about a half a body length lead. And that's Abby Fisher in lane one. And up top, lane five,
Rachel
we have
Zale.
Rachel Zale. Great showing by the seniors as yeah. Well as the underclassmen is Alex Matsoukas. Bringing it in for bragging rights, the 4x100, lane three. Lane one, Hopkinton
nice. Takes
1-2. Norton coming in lane four, taking the turn, and I think that is up top. Hopkinton will sweep. Oh, boy, lane two came in, I'm sorry. Oh, nope, Norton is still finishing up. So Hopkinton goes 1-2-3 across. Rachel Zale finishing up in lane five for Hopkinton. Norton will finish up. We'll get a final score. We'll stay on just because we like to hear the cheers at the end of the meet as well. See if the teams come up with anything new. John, any bets on what we might hear for?
No, I'm not going there.
Not going there?
Nope.
I think we could have an up the pool, down the pool. It's early in the season, but that's what. Maureen, any guesses as to what the final cheer might be? No. Norton comes in to the cheers as the meet has ended. We'll get a final score, but it is official that Hopkinton has won. They've gone 3-0. They are now 2-0 in the TVL with wins over Norton. And wait for it. Please hold. It's here somewhere. Medfield.
So I guess we'll be on the air again January 3rd?
Looks like we'll be back at it. I believe we're at Keith Tech again.
Yeah, I think so.
Hopefully they have that fixed, but I don't think so.
They may not. We'll wait for the final score and our cheers as we congratulate head coach Jeff Libby in his first home meet, home win. A decisive win against Norton as the Hillers swim and dive in all their depth. We're going to wait for the cheer, see if we got it. I'm going with up the pool, down the pool. Let's see what we got. Could be potato chip. Never know.
I like that one.
Well, it's going to be a minute. We might hear what Norton's got. We always look for some new creativity with these cheers at the end of the meet. Take a breather as the waves in the pool settle down. Finish the meet this evening. Unofficially, Hopkinton stopped scoring at 54. Here we go. Something new. You gotta love that. Bees, bees, bees like honey. We think Norton, something money. Cash money? Like that. I like something new. I gotta hand it to this Hiller team this year. The 17-18 edition of Hiller's Swim and Dive. As we will get ready to wrap up. Something a little bit different from Norton as well. All right.
Okay.
So for Kevin Legassi,
John Belger,
and Maureen Belger up on the camera, we thank you. Hillers win. We'll get a final score here. We'll announce that. Well, we might have results of the diving first. I see a lot of papers in the official's hand. We might have diving first. Wait for the diving scores for a moment. Heather Milani.
Filani, yep.
Nick with a score of 60.8. Jack Brennan, 222. Good diving day for Jack. For the divers. So there you have it. Final score, Hopkinton 54, Norton 28. Yeah. As a team shake hands, we will sign off.
We'll see you next year.